So long as footage exists of Brazil 1 Germany 7, it is likely that Brazilians will always be a little nervy about what kind of nonsense can happen when Neymar isn't around. The insecurity is ever more understandable at the moment, given the uncertainty surrounding their star turns broken metatarsal. Currently, the Brazilian Football Confederation and those around Neymar are giving off some mixed messages. The forward's father indicated the fracture to the fifth metatarsal of his right foot would take 6 to 8 weeks to heal, while Rodrigo Lasmar, the Brazil doctor, estimated 10 to 12 weeks. When he offered an update earlier this week, Lasmar added little beyond saying they would know more once 6 weeks had elapsed post-injury, so around the middle of April, considering the problem was sustained at the end of February. On the eve of a competition like the World Cup, it's always a little scary, Lasmar said. Indeed, if anything has been learned from metatarsal injuries, it is that they are rarely predictable. For instance, look back over a few suffered by England players. Michael Owen broke his fifth metatarsal in 2006 and it was predicted he would be out for 6 to 8 weeks, but returned 17 weeks later. Wayne Rooney was expected to be out for 8 weeks in 2004 and took 14. Ashley Cole, Steven Gerrard and Gary Neville all took between 2 and 13 weeks longer than the upper extreme of the estimates. So, it is not an exact science and Brazil's opening match of the World Cup is on June 17 to 15 weeks after his surgery. He should be fine, of course, but what if he isn't? This week and next are interesting in that regard, with Brazil facing Russia and Germany in warm-up matches. It will offer an interesting glimpse of tight contingency planning and, with it, focus will be given to the extremely impressive depth of the current Brazilian squad. If we take the pessimistic, and unlikely, view that Neymar will not be fit for the World Cup, then Juventus's on-loan winger Douglas Costa would likely take up the spot on the left of a front three. He would flank Firmino, with Willian on the right and Philippe Coutinho would go as an attacking threat just behind, or in his favored position on the left if tight doesn't fancy Costa. The side is better with Neymar in it, but it feels pretty deadly without him. And that, really, is a testament to the crop of players available. That attacking four leaves no space for striker Gabriel Jesus, and likewise Bordeaux right winger Malcolm, who is close to joining Bayern Munich. Lucas Moura of Tottenham is an option from the bench. Behind that line, Real Madrid's Casemiro and Fernandinho are solid in midfield, with Fabinho, Paulinho, Barcelona and Manchester City target Arthur, and Luis Gustavo as backup options. The defense of Dani Alves, Marquinhos, Thiago Silva and Real Madrid's Marcelo features only one man under the age of 29, Marquinhos, but is three-quarters of the PSG backline. It has been good enough to keep out Alexandro, the Juventus left-back, as well as David Luiz. In goal, they have competition between Roma's Alisson, who is wanted by Real Madrid and Liverpool, and Ederson of Manchester City. In all, it is not an entirely shabby national team, regardless of whether the unthinkable comes to pass with Neymar.